These are donations that come from other sources. They're not to be commingled. We're not gonna pay for porta potties out of that money.
I didn't ask you to pay.
Anymore. Well, I don't understand. What do you think we're gonna charge over?
That's all the money.
I said media. Yeah, media is not a.
Media, we've already taken the reduction. Right? You put in.
I mean.
Yeah, $650.
You received a grant for this year for books, right?
No.
The grant was for launch pads and projector, and that was all controlled and expensed already.
All separate.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we plan on spending money for media, and maybe it'll cover some supplies, let's say. I mean, we're not opposed to anything. But I don't wanna get confused what the town pays for and what the, well, I don't know what to call it, revolving account pays for. They're two different things.
And how much has the revolving account spent this year?
Are we done with this? Let's finish this discussion, because I have that coming next.
Well, if we wanna recap what the numbers are, I have added it up. I don't know if everybody's all got the same numbers. For heating, I have $1,353, then $1,500, $1,810, $1,810. $450 I put for the restrooms, $250 I put for the shovels. And then I put the wages back up. And that totaled up to $19,874. $19,874.
$74.
What was the?
That's our budget request.
What was the saving from the original amount?
Nineteen what?
$19,874.
That.
Plus $7,000.
Yeah, yeah. I added it twice.
But that's the maintenance value you can't find, all the shovels you can't find.
Right. That's the deal. Okay. Does you people do something now?
Well, I.
Do I move on to?
No, just keep going.
Okay, so now we're going to the, and I call this non-taxpayer funds. For the lack of a better way of referring it.
These are gross basis funds.
Which to me is just terrible to me. Anybody out there? Oops, that's true. Okay.
Do you have one more?
Okay. Huh?
Sharon asked if she could have one. Do you have one more?
Oh, I'm sorry, I don't.
Okay.
We don't have one either. Okay, so what you see, this is as of the beginning of November, or end of November, end of November. And actual cost through October was $42.21. That actual cost includes that grant deed version. So I take that out because it's a confusing entry.
What does ARPA stand for?
That's that projector.
American Rescue Plan Act. This was run by the Institute of Museums and Library Sciences, though, so this is separate from what the town is getting.
Okay. Oh. And then we have, so that makes the year-to-date expense for the non-taxpayer group, so if they get apples and oranges, people who can use it, well, as of November, we'd spend $13.90. Underway, and what we've now spent, isn't it correct, we've now spent $733 cost in the pipeline that didn't make the actual cost. Comes to $21.23, leaves a balance of $877 with the target goal of $3,000, and we're in the process of spending $877 right now to buy books. Another stuff. In fees. So this is what we have done so far this year.
Right. And again, yeah, that $3,000 is supposed to be spent the first part of the year. Yeah.
You have proved that to me. Prove that to me.
No.
Nobody's agreed to that. And we can't find to it. Money doesn't come in so we can pay all the bills up front. They come in with restrictions. Here's a donation, it's only for this.
It's only for children's books.
Or only for that, or only for this. It doesn't mean we can just run out and spend $3,000 right off the bat. We have
this here tells us nothing what you.
Well, what do you think you're gonna get from us? A detailed list of what we spent?
Yes.
Honestly, why that makes any difference?
It makes a lot of difference.
That's what this is, because if you have this, then when you've already started, well, you've done this for November 2021, but if you do it for the year, then you will be able to see what you're planning for the year and how it's going as it goes.
Nobody at the library understood this requirement that I talked to. Nobody. Well, they've heard of it, this reporting of the gone tax fair money. That's what I was told, but I tell you. So I've tried to develop something, and this is what I've got. Part of the expenditures to date are mischarges that we're just gonna swallow for the year.
What do you mean?
Like for example?
Porta potty charges. Supplies for the porta potty charged over here. Not doing that anymore.
Why was it charged?
Right, exactly.
This is a lot of confusion. You wouldn't believe how confused this is. We've been very confused.
What is the confusion?
Why?
Exactly.
And not send it to the bill to.
Before my time, before I could get involved, I've only been the chair since, I don't know, June or something. And Sue quit the day I became chair. She was the financial person. So basically we started from zero and trying to recreate how things get done.
All right, we have a new director, we have a new trustee, we have, we lost a staff member, we lost two staff members this year, we were training one of them.
In all of that confusion happened, I don't know why. And I don't want to accuse or blame somebody, it just happened. Now while I'm doing this, it isn't gonna happen again. I'm gonna stop that from happening. We had a several hour meeting this morning. What processes do we put in place to watch what we do and who does what? How do we check what's happening?
Well, you'll be able to know quarterly if you do this. And it won't go
I'm
for the whole
day. I'm willing to do that as long as all the other groups that need to do it, do it.
They're supposed to, yes.
Well, we aren't doing it by ourselves. We're not being singled out.
Well, when the bill comes in, you don't automatically pay it to that. You give it to the office. What's confusing
well,
about that?
He says he's, I asked him that exact question. He said because he only came on in June, he didn't know what had happened before.
Well, whoever was there.
No, but that's my question. Why would you not tell me?
I'm not accusing anybody, but if you have a damn job, you do it right.
Okay. And as I said, now that I'm overseeing it, it won't happen anymore. And we're going to have a process much more manageable.
Because I know that you're supposed to turn in certain reports to get money from the town.
I'm unaware of what reports.
Okay.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know what they're called. They have a specific name.
Yes.
So, do you know what they are?
I'm not sure what you're talking about.
The reports that the library is supposed to give the town to collect their, to get their bills paid.
It's just a payment request, isn't it?
That's what we've been doing.
I don't know. I think so.
It doesn't mean that. It sounds like
you know what I mean, Ed?
Yes, I do.
Umbrellas.
I can't think of what they call.
Well, when you find the form, let me know. I'll look at it and see what we can do. We're unaware of it.
I'm not looking for no damn form.
Well, I'm not going to hunt for it. If you want it
done. Well, if you're telling him that there's a rule that they should follow, but you're not going to give him any assistance to follow the rule, then he's going to proceed in.
Are you talking about when a bill comes in just to a request for payment? Or something different?
It concerned the gross budget. Combination of the gross budget and the.
You're saying gross based budget. The fund of the Civil Society Center can only be spent on very specific things.
Exactly. So,
so all the money that they've got can only be spent on very specific
yes.
things. Yes. So you mean he's got to give you chapter and verse of exactly what it is that it can only be spent. I mean, you're just sort of running a tally of the monies that come
yes.
in.
Yes.
Because it's very easy to do.
Well, we used to
running a tally is different than two books here, 10 books there. this desk.
Right, but she would take a discretion, tell us how much the.
Who's she? Who is she?
The librarian took it, had in her checking account every month.
Yeah.
How much was deposited, how much she took and spent there towards subscriptions.
Well, the only difference is that this is a summary, it isn't broken up by month. If you want me to write 9 months worth of numbers, I'd be glad to do it. But you're going to get the same total. What's it going to affect?
I think there's a form.
There is.
That Sue has for that.
Yes.
Right, because I mean, $733, ooh, I spent that on shoes in November.
Oh, for specifically reporting involving the librarian's director's account? Yeah, that's, I'm sure that's a form that was created years ago that Deb always used and Stacy probably used, right?
Yeah.
I would never get a form like that.
It's never come to the budget.
This doesn't go to you.
Okay.
This is the trustees of the libraries and with their stuff to go.
I know, I give my receipts for my spending to the trustees and that's...
No, that's what I'm saying. Don't take it as towards you, it's towards the trustees. They're supposed to do it.
Well, we can't do what we don't know anything about. One, and two, we'll be very cautious and very concerned that we're not treated differently than the other departments within the same requirements. So whatever it is you tell me we have to do, I'm going to follow up with people to find out whether that applies to every group or just us.
But this is where I'm being really thrown back at, is you're saying that every group is that you want to be treated and some groups aren't being treated the same.
Well, there's some groups that don't have to report anything at all. They just get the money, spend the money, and nobody has any insight into that at all. Isn't that right?
And
they have an annual report that has a few summary numbers. They can't tell us anything.
Who?
Getting right? Who?
Exactly. Yeah. If you're going to sit there and make these, George, we need to know so we can take and find out where this is happening.
Well, I didn't see any cemetery annual report in the annual report. I didn't see a year-end report for the cemetery in the annual report.
There is.
Where did I ask you about this form?
Not only did it already up, but I don't know where the
pictures are going. Right, exactly.
What?
Oh,
it's in that
form.
Where?
If there is.
Where is it? Stop with the other ones.
Yeah, that would be good.
I looked all through it and I didn't see it.
George, I have a question. I got an email from Dan Clark saying we have to pay out the interest.
Yeah.
Right. And then I got a follow-up saying the money was going to be.
That's correct.
Which is fine, because I didn't know.
This is the year before I had a question.
I don't know how that got started.
This is where all the
other because the trustees
see the ambulance.
But I mean, that money you know is dedicated towards
solid waste.
Right.
But there's no cemetery.
Yes, but what she's looking for is a checking account of the cemetery. The cemeteries don't have a checking account, so you ain't gonna find one.
I guess not.
No, exactly. If one of those exists, you're not gonna find it in the book.
I look forward to getting the form and seeing what it is.
I thought cemetery had.
Yes, about 10, 15 years ago, they had.
And if there is one, she'll see.
There was problems in it
and maybe
with the previous trustees.
I could.
So it got taken away. I transferred it from the previous trustees right into the town. So that is in the town's hands, right in financial. Because the trustees before, there was stuff that the town was lucky they never got audited on because...
We get audited every year.
I know, and there's a lot of things that go on that the auditors don't find.
Yeah, it's a pretty poor audit.
Yes.
Well, then we ought to get some new auditors.
Yes.
They're really important.
Because.
All I see is very important.
The, yeah.
George wants to know if you got anything more for.
Yeah, what more do we need to do? We're going to do porta potty business, we took that action.
Are we voting on this now?
See if we can find some form to help us know what we're supposed to do.
Yeah, so what's the.
I think it was something to do with your payments.
$19,800.
That's the payments, maybe they got to be broken down.
I don't know.
That's what they want.
Yeah, I don't know either.
This town is so messed up, God knows if they'll ever get straightened out.
Well, what is it?
I don't think it's a good one.
Yep, that's all right.
About $2,000.
This is really.
I'm not fixing nothing, I'm done.
I'm sorry, did I miss something?
No.
I recommend, I motioned that we accept the library budget for 2022 for $19,874.
I second that.
And before we go any further, Pam, I'm going to take and ask that you not make a motion because of George being a trustee and you are his wife, so there's going to be a conflict of interest.
I make the motion. $19,874.
We have to be careful.
Oh, there you go, so.
Right, exactly, conflict of interest.
Because we get accused of it all the time.
What?
We get accused of it all the time. So she made the motion, I'll second.
There's only, in the city of Hinchinbrook, it's laws change, there's only one conflict of interest.
I'm saying provisionally, there might be a slight adjustment to that if the porta potty people come.
Correct, pending whatever that outcome is.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed say nay.
Thank you. Okay, porta potty.
Because only one person is going on the fees.
Porta potty, so there are thousands of competing porta potty engineers.
Hey, Mabel's coming, next one. Well.
It's what it's telling us.
Possibly.
Well, that seems to be what it's saying, flying different way.
We can do the selectmen because that's a few changes.
So we are dismissed.
Well, happily that you got it. You caught it, right?
Well, thank you. Drive carefully, make it from getting slipped.
Just so everybody knows, ours are due January 11th.
We did.
We have to be in. Public hearing will be January 14th at 6.
What day is it, Friday?
Friday.
What time is it, here?
Yes.
Oh, well, there goes our audience.
We meet earlier.
Bye.
Has been here, are we officially adjourned?
You guys are, I'm not.
I don't know how this works.
When's public hearing at?
January 14th.
At 6?
Well, you got it.
Yes.
6 o'clock here.
How long do you think you'll be here?
That's good.
What?
How long do you think you'll be here?
I think, how much longer are you going to be?
Not long.
I mean, we're just doing the final thing.
Oh, I'm sitting.
We're just selecting.
The selecting, there's going to be some changes made.
Have we made them or?
No, because I went through it, I caught stuff that nobody else took and caught and.
Well, there were several things.
Yes.
I mean, I think tan, I understand you want to keep that tan there in case we do need it, but $4,000 for something that's not been used, I think, is a lot. We can put it down to $1,500.
Well.
Doesn't have to be $4,000. We're not going to use it.
That's coming next week.
That's next week?
Yeah.
And what they were going to talk about was the postage.
Yes.
Because that was so low, postage, rental box, executive, oh, there's two of them.
Yes.
That must just be rental box? Rental box must be $62. Where's postage then?
They screwed up, and nobody caught it, because they had it for $130.
Yes.
And
it's $871 was already spent.
Right.
So what did they decide?
$1,300.
So what did they want, and how much should it
be? They wanted the $130.
$130.
Oh, maybe it was the wrong.
Well, no, they.
No, like we written about.
Maybe it was the wrong decimal thing or something.
No, because I had to go down through and add everything all up, and it bottom line is more because of it.
Yeah.
It was $1,000 last year.
Right.
And it's still $871, and the postage is going on.
Yeah. It already has.
So $1,300.
Yes.
Good. I don't think we need this town thing.
No, that can be taken down. Even $500.
But what happens?
We haven't used it. We haven't used it in years. Peg solved that problem, use it up. We haven't needed it since.
We only had town originally because we paid taxes once a year. And we had to borrow to pay things off until taxes came in December, which is why we switched to twice a year, and we've never had to pay town since.
Right. So that, I think, is a high number for there.
I don't think you need anything in that line. Put $1,000 in it if you have to feel what you've got.
We wanted to leave it there in case it was a need for it, but...
Well, I don't know, but if you did that, then you could pad the budget out infinitely.
That's right.
It's possible.
So what do we want to put it to then? 500 or 1,000?
500. Nominal amount. It can go to something else, which is overspent.
Those are mostly the things, I guess. The electric. The electric, we said, was high at 45 because they only spent 28.
Mess around with the electric.
Is that the end of November? Or did it end up being for the end of November? Or what was it? General government buildings.
Yeah.
General government buildings.
Or
electric. It's still only 28. So 45, I thought was high. I had written down 3,300, which should still be plenty because there's only one more month.
Well, the trouble
45 is all the month.
There are things that get accrued to the end of the year, like paying Ed his loan.
Not under electric bill.
No. But I thought you were saying, for generally speaking.
No. And then your question to. Postage and box rental for 62.
That must just be the box.
The selectmen get a box and the treasurer gets a P.O. box.
And that's in here? That's not in her? Right. Or treasurer, and, treasurer, yes.
That's
her box.
Right, that's her box.
All right, so then that, she's not doing postage. Treasurer doesn't send anything.
No.
But we needed to put it up there. All right. But the electric, well, I think 45 is awful high for electric. They're going to spend 3,000. By the end of the year, it'll be 3,000. So if we put 3,300, 4,500 there, we could put a 3,500, but I think 4,500 is a little bit high.
What do they got?
Electric bills in general government.
That's what they're looking
for. 4,500?
Yeah.
And they've only spent 28.
Take it down to 35. Electric rates.
35. All right, 35.
You make a motion.
I'll make a motion that we reduce that number to 3,500.
Okay.
Somebody second it?
I second it.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed say nay.
Nay.
We didn't do all that for tan.
No, you didn't do anything on tan yet. So, what are you doing on tan?
500. I motion that we put the tan expense down to 500 instead of 4,000.
I'll second that.
All those in favor say aye.
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 Opposed say nay.
Nay.
And then we already put the health agencies up to 9,000.
Did you make a motion on that?
Wages was, this was his maintenance business.
I made that motion, yes, awesome.
I don't understand why the wages for the general government buildings has gone up so much.
Because they hired a maintenance man.
What?
Because they hired a maintenance man. That, I asked that, and that was, man.
Yeah, but didn't we have a maintenance man in 2021?
What?
The maintenance.
We had, $1,250. And 900 expenses, we must have had a maintenance man.
He doesn't expect to do this, make it his life's work.
That's not the point.
Well, there wasn't anybody.
Unless it's so attractive, yeah.
Are there more jobs that are gonna come along that need to be done?
What do you mean, more jobs?
Well, the amount is going from 1,250 to 6,000. That's three times, four times. It's gone up a lot, and I don't understand why. We had a maintenance person doing something, because we spent $1,000, so somebody was doing something.
We didn't have a maintenance person.
This is a completely new person. The 1,200 was not, what was the budgeted amount for? I mean, it just says wages, it doesn't say.
I don't know, because I don't know who put the $5,800 in there.
That's just a big jump.
That's a wage line, yeah.
And I'm hearing things they don't do.
I got my finger right there.
But I'm not hearing they're gonna do that much more for four times the budget.
Oh, all right. No, it's this one here.
Oh, I don't know, $6,000?
$838 was spent.
Yep, but that was probably for miscellaneous people here and there. Cindy is the one you should have asked, she was here.
Was she?
She's the one that's in the office with Sue all the time.
She ratted. That's our next meeting.
She might not be here next meeting.
Really?
She might not be here.
Well, some of them.
Oh.
Wouldn't that be the thing too?
Well, yeah. And I think if you're curious, if you wanna know what's in the selectmen's budget, because the selectmen's secretary, and I believe Cindy, put this together, so.
Well, I asked about the work wages, and in front of Cindy and Sue.
Did you get an answer?
Yeah, they said, because they hired a new maintenance man, Bill Paul.
Really?
Yep.
What's he being paid hourly?
No idea.
$14 an hour.
Hmm?
$14.
Oh, you know that?
Yep.
All right, I believe you. I thought you were gonna say.
But what I don't get is, where is the four times the work gonna come from? That's my question. What is the four times the work?
Well, he can shovel the steps of the library.
Nope, they don't shovel. That was already said, they're not gonna shovel. Maintenance, $14.
Well, he's not anxious because he's retired and wants things to do. He can shovel the steps.
That, I just don't.
Maybe he has a bad back, I don't know.
All right, so what are you doing with it?
That's up to you guys.
So, have you got a bottom line number or adjusted bottom line number? Or are you going to keep changing everything up? I mean, this whole thing still needs to be discussed about the wages, it seems to me. Well, we just paid for it, we're taking half of it, we're taking it from town.
Well, the only thing that we had changed last time, really, was
the
putting the health agencies up 1,000 again. So it wasn't down 1,000. Went back up to 9 where it has always been for a long time. So that was an increase. But now we've got another decrease, and then we've got an increase and a decrease. So we have to go through and add it all up again. But what are we gonna leave that $6,000 there. I motion that we bring that $6,000 under the wages, under general government buildings, down to $4,000. That's more than doubling it still, it's at least not quadrupling it.
Look at me.
I don't know what all the rest of the work there is to do.
Somebody want a second?
I don't know enough about it.
No, I think if you guys want to change it, you should talk to Sue and Cindy.
Ed said he did.
I don't care if he talked to him in the office. You weren't there, she wasn't there, I wasn't there. Where are we?
All right, what are we doing?
And if you want to change it, go ahead and change it. Who gives a rat's ass?
Well, I think we don't. I motioned to change it and nobody said anything, so I guess we're leaving it.
Streetlights should get bumped up $100. There's $3,000 right now, and they got one bill, it's going to be $300. Just under $300.
There ain't enough street lights in this town anyway. We like them live in the dark.
Well, some of them were turned off to save money. And what did you say?
I said there weren't enough street lights in Grafton anyway.
We're putting it out
there. All right, when you're driving up the road, say you want to go up Cherry Hill.
There used to be a light there.
There used to be a light in that vicinity.
Yeah.
There ain't no more.
I didn't know Cindy was going to walk up.
Me either.
I thought that was our last thing, and then suddenly she's gone.
I think she was supporting George.
I can't
remember. Want me to add it all up? There's a lot of numbers to add up. I mean, these are like subtotals or something.
Yes, they are. Those are subtotals.
This is financial admin, and the subtotal is above it.
Right. But they suggested having them come in, Sue or Cindy.
So that's next week, too?
Yeah.
All right. So then we're done. So next week we're doing selectmen, highway, fire, ambulance.
Ambulance, welfare.
Welfare we did.
They requested come in.
Who did?
Welfare.
Well, I can understand because they only had like 3 clients because everybody is scared of Cindy.
Cindy is a welfare person?
Well, she was in the beginning.
Who is now?
And now it's Heather Hunter.
Oh. All right. And so they want to come back and talk?
I wouldn't.
It was $15,000. We put it at $15,000.
Right. It was $15,000, so you just left it.
Yeah. And what? So what's the problem?
I have no clue.
No idea. I was given a memo saying that she wants to come in.
Heather wants to come in?
In a way, I'm sorry I'm not going to be here next year because I'll tell you what. All those budgets came in. They should have gone through the selectmen, then they should have come immediately to the budget committee so that when you started, you didn't have this cluster that you have. This is terrible.
It's getting late. We just keep...
And you've got to keep going. And, you know?
Well, all right, so they'll come. She's coming in. We have to do it all next week.
Yep.
Well, we won't have all that. Somehow those were long discussions. Hopefully next week there won't be long discussions.
So we're done. The next meeting.
Yes.
All right. So
next Thursday.
Next Thursday at the same.
Yeah.
This is crazy.